an emotionally articulate woman. And I remember going
around...
You didn't
film the car, the train going past,
yeah.
Well, I could have been informed by then.
It's just so tiring living without an emotion.
Yeah.
And it really got through to me because I thought
that's the thing.
I've ever said something that feels to me objectively sort of articulate and true and real. And I did feel really sorry for
And that's an incredibly sad thing to feel compelled to share with your children. But to be able to say that to be able to teenage and stuff in there.
I really got through to me because I was sort of, I understood what it I was old enough to understand what that meant. And that was the case. My dad is not a man of those kind of emotions. Having said that, I did a TV documentary and there's bits in that which I think are incredibly emotional. I think you saw that equally, though I'm not watching anything else by David. But at the end of it...
That's the documentary you made, but let me help you.
Well, at the end of that documentary, I am asked by the director, oh, did your dad used to tell you that he loved you? I said, of course he did.
But interestingly, in that documentary, when you're asked to talk about that, and you then change slightly what your father said.
Yeah, well, I can't say that.
No, you can't. But it's interesting that you did that, and I think it's interesting because I think you have such a kind of strongly developed, almost unchangeable idea of who he is.